most welcome to this Eucharistic celebration. Today being the 13th Sunday of their time, year A. And today's readings, they are inviting us to be charitable. Let charity and hospitality be another sign of God's presence among us, especially by welcoming those people that God has sent to us, to minister to us. For sure, when we do that, God's blessings shall overflow in our families and also in our lives. I know that we have our particular intentions, the needs of our loved ones, ourselves, and all those that are requesting us to remember them in our prayers. Besides those intentions that we have, we also have the following for our brothers and sisters requesting us to remember them. Florence Kiragu, praying for her daughter Dawn Jacinta Kiragu, who is celebrating her 18th birthday. God's guidance and blessings as she prepares for KCSE to be over her. And she also prayed for the healing for corona patients. Mr. and Mrs. DC are thanking God for all his blessings. And they are praying for God's blessings and protection upon the family and their work. Cecilia Mwachi is also thanking God for blessing and protecting her business and family. We are praying for more blessings and protection. Juliet Cheruto is thanking God for his blessings and protection, and also prays for God's continued guidance and wisdom in her decisions. We also pray for the quick and full recovery of Rispa, who underwent surgery. Joyce Isika is praying for her diabetes, Ethiopia Isika, and she also prays for her brothers Peter Mutia and William Kutuku, that God may bless them. We also pray for Guardian Benjamin Mwendo, that God may restore his health through his illness. We pray for all parents who are troubled by the sickness of their children, afflicted in any way, that God may grant them the grace of serenity. We pray for the intentions of Father Timothy Ogutu, that God's will be done in his priestly ministry. And we also pray for Clemens Mwalimbo, who is thanking God for the gift of her family, for enabling her start a new business. She prays for good health and protection from the coronavirus and other diseases. With these intentions and those that are hidden in our hearts, we start this Mass in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, for our sacrifice to be pleasing before God, let us call to mind our sins and therefore ask for God's forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault, therefore I ask Blessed Mary, the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
Thank you.
Let us pray. O God, who through the grace of adoption chose us to be children of light, grant, we pray, that we may not be wrapped in the darkness of error, but always be seen to stand in the bright light of truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
Responsorial Psalm response: I will sing forever your mercies, O Lord. Oh, Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans, chapter 6, verse 3 to 4, then 8 to 11. Brethren, all of us who have been baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death. We were buried, therefore, with him by baptism into death, so that as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might walk in newness of life. But if we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. For we know that Christ, being raised from the dead, will never die again. Death no longer has dominion over him. The death he died to sin once for all, but the life he lives to God. So you also must consider yourselves dead to sin, and alive to God in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord. Kindly stand up for the gospel proclamation.
The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. At that time, Jesus said to his apostles, "He who loves father and mother more than me is not worthy of me. And he who loves son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And he who does not take his cross and follow me is not worthy of me. He who finds his life will lose it, and he who loses his life for my sake will find it. He who receives you receives me, and he who receives me receives him who sent me. He who receives a prophet because he is a prophet, shall receive a prophet's reward. And he who receives a righteous man, because he is a righteous man, shall receive a righteous man's reward. And whoever gives to one of these little ones even a cup of cold water, because he is a disciple, truly I say to you, he shall not lose his reward. The Gospel of the Lord. My dear brothers and sisters, a happy Sunday to you all. It's a very beautiful day given to us by God Himself. And wherever we are following us on Twitter, as Peter calls it, that is on Facebook Live and on YouTube, he always says it's from Twitter. We thank God, and let us build communion and together reflect on the Word of God. Thank you, Joseph, for that beautiful psalm. Sometimes I really wish God would bless me with a voice like yours. Thank you so much. The first reading of today is from the second book of Kings, chapter 4, verse 8 to 11, and verse 14 to 16. And the beautiful psalm that our brother led us in singing is Psalm 89. I'll sing forever of your mercies, O Lord. Second reading, St. Paul's letter to the Romans, chapter 6, verse 3 to 4, and verse 8 to 11. And the gospel is from Matthew, chapter 10, verse 37 to 42. This morning, I would like us to stay with the first reading. And because whatever I'm going to preach overlaps with the gospel of the day, I want to focus on this first reading, the story of the woman of Shunem. The Shunammite woman, a woman whose name is not given. But even though we do not know her by name, this Shunammite woman features in the plan of God. You may never come from a prominent family, you may never have a godfather or a godmother, but each one of us is known to God by name. So let's allow this woman to minister to us. I want to highlight seven key moments in the story of this woman. And I will conclude with five lessons we can learn from her. We heard that Elisha and his servant Gehazi, whom Bible scholars say was his nephew, while they were going about the business of prophecy, they would pass by the home of this influential woman. And the first time we hear about an action that she does, the first moment, is when she persuades Elisha to come in and eat. The first moment is of the woman persuading, urging, begging the prophet of God to come in and eat. It is not Elijah who went looking for food, knocking at her door. No. It was a woman who opened her house and invited Elisha. And it was not once. Became a habit that every time Elisha passed that way, he could branch into this woman's house and have a meal. Even if I were the one, I would do the same. And I would make sure I pass that direction more often. We have a gentleman back home called Ongidi. Ongidi has been releasing very practical songs, very nice hits. And one of the songs sung by Ongidi is a song called Oseso. Singing about the stomach, that everything we work for in this world is for the stomach. And the best relationship is in the stomach. Whoever feeds you, gives you life. Oseso. That the best relationship is in the stomach. The way to a man's heart is through the stomach. This is what this woman did. Feeding a prophet of God spontaneously without the prophet asking. Number two. She perceives something. That is what the word of God said. There was something about Elisha that even her husband had not yet recognized. God has given our sisters, our mothers, the gift of instinct, the gift of perception, the ability to discern. And if you have a relationship with your mother, or with your wife, or with your sister, it happens so many times, just by seeing you, they will know if everything is okay, or if something is amiss. This woman was a woman of discernment. She went beyond the outside appearance. Thus, we live in a world that celebrates what is outside. We live in a world where everybody wants to create an image, a bigger than thou image around themselves. People living on loans, defrauding people so that they can live large and finance their lifestyles. Don't fall into the trap of staying only with the outside. Ask God for the gift of discernment, that you may go deeper and know the inner values and the principles of people around you. This was a woman of perception. Number three. Once she perceived something, she went to speak to her husband. The two had a discussion on how to help Elisha. She influenced her husband, opened the eyes of her husband to see something that up to this time he never knew. She opened the horizon, broadened the perspective, enlarged the vision of her husband. And she was able to convince him that together they should put up a house, not next to the servant quarters, not in the yard, very far away from the main house, but on the rooftop. They built an upper room for the prophet of God. They were not building for Elisha. They were actually creating room for the word of God to stay right in their home. So whenever you are doing your plans for your new homes, or you are thinking of extending your house because you feel you need more space, do you factor in an upper room, a prayer room? Do you even go to a larger extent and just put up a house in case one of the priests, one of the sisters comes to visit you? Even your own children know that is a house reserved for the servants of God. This couple, through the influence of this woman, they were able to read from the same page. They held a positive discussion about Elisha on how to make better his life. I pray that those who are going to discuss about you may hold positive discussions about improving your life. If your bosses are meeting to discuss about who to promote, your name may feature. When doctors are meeting to discuss how to handle your medical condition, their discussions are going to improve your life. If your children are going to meet to discuss how you have brought them up, they are going to have a positive discussion that will bring you peace as a parent. The influence of this woman and the husband who listened to her. Point number four, the prophetic reward. Jesus is talking about in the gospel of today. Elisha felt that we should do something because of the generosity of this family. We should intervene and pray to God for them. And so he asked his servant, what can we do? And Gehazi says, this woman is childless. Her husband is equally old. Let us give them a child. Elisha says, call her in. And there comes the prophecy. This time, next year, you are going to hold your own child. My dear friends, sometimes it is good to allow God to prophesy in our lives. When you go to kneel before him, claim some of the prophecies. Be like Anna. Promise God, if you do this for me, I'm going to offer this son to serve you all the days of his life. So I don't know what you want God to prophesy in your life. Everybody is praying that 2021 will be different from 2020. We want this year to go by so fast, so that we can turn the page and begin a new chapter. So what is it that you like God to do for you this time next year? Some are praying that this time next year they will be married. This time next year they will be homeowners. This time next year they will not be staying when everybody is coming over to receive communion. They will have a wedding in church so that they can open their hearts to receive Jesus. This time next year, what is your petition to your God? Do you want to be in the same place? Or do you want God to wipe away your tears? Number five, if you read further, the woman got a child. And one day, the child was out there with the father, and he began crying, "My head, my head, my head." And the father said, "What is it?" He said, "My head is aching." And the father said, "Go to your mother." That is what our fathers always do. When they encounter problems, they send us to our mothers. When we are doing very well in school, they will parade us before their friends and tell everybody, "This is my son. This is my daughter. He took after me. Anafanana tu na mimi, hata tabia, hata kutembea, hata nani rangi ya matumbo yake ni kama yangu." Do you know, they want to identify us with them whenever we are making it. But when we land into problems, sura kama ya mama yako. So the father sent this boy to his mother. Dear friends, the boy died in the laps of his mother. Sometimes the things we have longed for, the petitions we have fasted for, prayed for in our lives, die. They bring us a lot of pain. When the child died, the Jewish custom demanded that the child should be immediately buried in the family cave. What did this woman do? The Shunammite woman took her dead boy and went and placed him on the bed of the prophet, where Elisha used to sleep. Then she began the journey going to Mount Carmel to look for Elisha. Why? It is only Elisha, the prophet of God, who could help this woman understand what was going on in her life. Remember the journey of our mother Mary to the hill country to look for her cousin Elizabeth. You need sometimes to make that journey, to go to people who can open your eyes, open your heart, to understand and accept what is going on in your life, because sometimes it is too much. What has died in your life and you can't comprehend? It even makes you angry at God. The word of God doesn't make meaning anymore. You do not want to go back to that church you are contemplating going to another church. You are running in the wrong direction. Run to Mount Carmel. Go to Elisha that he may explain and make you understand what is going on. Place whatever is dead in the right place. Not in the cave, not buried away, but where the hand of God can reach. Point number six. As she goes to Mount Carmel, Elisha sees her from a distance, and he also perceives there is something going on in the life of this woman, and so he sends his servant Gehazi, run and go and meet the Shunammite woman and ask her three questions. Is everything okay with your husband? Is everything okay with yourself? Is everything okay with your son? Three questions. But I want to focus on the response of this woman. When Gehazi meets her and asks her the three questions, she simply replies to the servant that it is well. It is well. Dear friends, when she reaches Elisha, she grabs his feet. The feet in the scriptures mean adoration, mean worship. So this woman grabs the feet of Elisha with tears, a lot of pain in her heart. She holds on to where her solution will come from. She never replied Gehazi. So don't tell everybody your problems. Don't get into a matatu and begin lamenting to whoever is seated next to you how your husband has become a monster in the house. They will not help you. Stop broadcasting your issues to every Tom, Dick, and Harry. Know where to take your problems. Know in whom to confide. She never told Gehazi what was going on. She took her problem to Elisha because she knew her solution would come from Elisha. Elisha sends Gehazi, take the staff, go quickly, go and pray over the son. But the woman says, I'm not going to release your feet until you come with me. And so Elisha goes, finds Gehazi has tried all the shenanigans, nothing happened, the son was still lying dead. The prophet closes the door and remains in the room alone with the son of this woman. And the word of God says that Elisha stretched himself on the dead boy, his mouth touching the mouth of this boy, his eyes touching the eyes of the dead boy, and his two hands touching the hands of the corpse. Reaction, the boy began getting warm. There was life coming into him, but he never got up. Elisha paced around the room again, most likely telling God to do something. Eventually, he went back a second time, lying down again on top of the boy, mouth to his mouth, eyes to his eyes, hands to his hands. The boy coughed seven times. and he came back to life. And he called in the Shunammite woman and told her, take your son, he's alive. What did the woman do? She never ran to the son. She again went and grabbed the feet of Elisha and thanked him before she went to take her son. Those are the seven moments in the life of this woman. I just get five lessons for you and for me. Number one, let us be spontaneous in our generosity. Don't wait for people to beg. If you have to help, help. Don't wait until the situation is desperate. Don't wait until your mother, your father, is on the sick bed. Sasa ndio unaenda with a boot full of food. Enda pia mko ukule kidogo. The old man, the old woman, when he was looking for something to eat, he was a burden to you. Now that they are almost dying, that is when you want to try and wash your conscience so that their spirit may never haunt you. Be spontaneous in your generosity. Don't wait for people to beg, to massage your ego. Don't wait for priests to preach here warning of dire consequences, using the book of Malachi, that whatever you are saving, the pockets are going to get torn before you do something. Be spontaneous in your generosity. Number two, be a person of perception. Discern. And we know we encounter these things every day along our pastoral work. You've come working in Kitengela. You meet a young man, don't know where he comes from. After 2 weeks, you have fallen in love, gone to stay in his house. Jamaa analala na morota kama Gloria Bedford. The whole night snoring, you may think there is a thunder in the house. By the time he takes you home, his mother tells you, okay, pika samaki na rice, we are going to get visitors. 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock, you're becoming sleepy. Unauliza mother-in-law, where are the visitors? She tells you, relax. Wageni wetu ni wa usiku. Around midnight, 3 pythons come. And she tells you to feed them, initiating you into witchcraft. Because you wanted your story to be the story of Simon Makonde. Haraka ni ya nini? Pray over some of the decisions you make. Pray over some of the commitments you make in life. Discern, perceive, go beyond what you see outside. Getting married, you brought a woman back into your house, into your life. Before anything, nataka arusi. Kumbe, you got married to a woman who is so beautiful from outside, but ndani anakaa kama exhausted. You know, take your time. Patience pays. Be a woman, a man of perception. Discern. Number three, influence in a positive way. Open the eyes of others to new reality. Influence your colleagues, your friends to pray. Influence them to come to church. Influence them to read the scriptures. Life is about influencing others, inspiring others. Are you an influential person? Can you open people's eyes to a new horizon, a new reality? If people have a perception about somebody that is wrong, can you also take the risk and tell them, what you think about so and so is wrong. This is how I know him. This is how I know her. This woman was a positive influencer. Point number seven, number four. Even when she was in pain, having lost her son, weeping. In fact, her husband asked her, why are you going to Carmel? Today is not a Sabbath day. It is not even the new moon. Why are you going to Carmel? Sometimes people wonder, why are you going to church every day? Why do you spend your 1 hour in your silent meditation? So when they told you Mapili, it's enough. Everybody is doing that. Even in that moment of pain, God knew, this woman knew that God had a purpose in that pain. A woman who understands the purposes of God are not only when things are rosy and going on well, but they can discern the will of God even when they are fallen down because of the weight of the cross. The story of Jesus today, whoever wants to be my disciple should carry his or her cross every day and follow me. She didn't run away from God, didn't run away from church. She actually went in pursuit of God. Help me understand. The final lesson. Be bold. Be bold. Even when there was a dead child in her house, she still told Gehazi, it is well. Be bold. Allow God to have the final say. These are words so many people have used in that moment when the rubber meets the tarmac. Things are really falling apart. With tears, with a very heavy heart, even when you are burying your own mother, burying your father, burying your beloved son or daughter, these words have spontaneously come out of our mouths. It is well with my soul. When the man that you began life with in Katweke, in Kibera, sleeping on the floor, God has blessed you, Menua Shanga Kitengela. You put up your home. God has promoted your husband. He's now a director of a company. When you have paid school fees for that lady you thought you are going to marry, polished up her life, made her somebody, and then along the way she got a job. From the loans you are taking working in EPZ, she's now a school teacher. She thinks, I should get somebody else. Or maybe you had a son or a daughter together. They are forcing you to pay for child upkeep. The lot of pain, you know very well that they are using those children to mint money from you. Send with a lot of pain. Even after sending, instead of just telling you thank you, I have received, they keep quiet, or at best send you a message, dead beat husband. Many men have said, it is well. Dear friends, it is well, because just like this Shunammite woman, God had the final say. I pray that this time next year, we shall not talk about the story of the Shunammite woman. We shall talk about your story and my story, because God is in charge.
We pray for the church, for the Father of Francis, bishops, priests, deacons, religious men and women, even catechists, all the faithful people of God, catechumen, that they may be faithful to announce the word of God with a lot of love, passion, commitment, in all circumstances, and that they may find kind people to welcome them, the Lord of generosity and hospitality, and to support them in their mission. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For the heads of governments, states, those who are in civil authority, and even political institutions, that their good Lord, through His Holy Spirit, may touch their hearts, that they may perceive the needs of God's people, that they may eradicate evils like corruption and all kinds of discrimination, that they may think about these needs, and that they may come to the aid of the people of God. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For the conversion of many people in the world who are still sitting and living in the darkness, that through the Holy Spirit they may convert to know God by accepting the word announced, that they may change their ways, and they may be always so foster love, peace, dialogue, generosity in the world. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For those who have asked us to pray for them and with them, they are sick spiritually, even discouraged, becoming hopeless. They are hungry. They have no food nor drink. They have no clothes. And some have no sense of direction. The youth, who also lose hope because of unemployment, many people who are lacking jobs. We think and we pray for the orphans, the widows, the bereaved, and all those who are going through difficult moments, that the good Lord may send help to them, and that they may feel your love and your compassion. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for ourselves, various intentions and different needs. We also pray for those who have nobody to pray for them, and the vulnerable who have nobody to defend them. We also pray for those who have asked Mass, those who are lying on our prayers. That the Lord may bless our intentions, good intentions of heart. That the Lord may be generous and bless us, and He may always be favorable and generous. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Now turn to our Mother Mary. Our Mother, you know the needs of the world, you know the needs of our families, you know our challenges. Let me ask you to present these petitions to your Son. Even those we have not spoken, those even we don't know, that you are unfailing help. May always be with us, and that you may pray with us and for us to your Son. As we say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and we are forever. We ask peace through Christ our Lord. Amen. Thank you.
acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who graciously accomplish the effects of your mysteries, grant, we pray, that the deeds by which we serve you may be worthy of these sacred gifts. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed man and woman in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made and forever praise you in your mighty works through Christ our Lord. And so with all the angels praise you as in joyful celebration we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and giving thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Let us proclaim the mystery of our faith. Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Lord, we pray upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, the blessed apostles, the glorious martyrs, Saint Monica, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, John Obala, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you, in your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you, at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Now, faithful to our Savior's command and divine teaching, we dare pray the words he taught us together.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Thank you.
Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy of you to lay hands on my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be.
May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Thank you.
Father, I pray for them that they may be one in us, that the world may believe that you have sent me, says the Lord. Let us pray. May this divine sacrifice we have offered and received fill us with life, O Lord, we pray, so that bound to you in lasting charity, we may bear fruit that lasts forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Take this time to thank Almighty God for his favors, his grace, the graces that we have received since we were born, and particularly today, the grace that we have received through this Eucharistic celebration. Let our lives be a thanksgiving song every moment of our existence. Thank you, my brother priest, for participating in praying through this Eucharistic celebration for God's people scattered because of this coronavirus, most of them locked in their houses because of these corona restrictions that are going on. Thank you for your fervent prayers, and God always bless you. Father Peter, Father Godfrey, through your lips, God has spoken to his people. The word that is written has been audible enough. Thank you for proclaiming it in the reverence and respect. Thank you, Father Bernard, for your wholesome, wonderful, beautiful, and powerful homily today. Pray that God, who has inspired you to speak to the hearts of his people, may always enrich you with every spiritual blessing. Remember the last lessons that he actually enumerated in a very powerful way about this Shunammite woman. Together with our household, may we always be spontaneous in our generosity. Square for America. One, let us be spontaneous. Let us be people of perception, going beyond whatever the eyes can behold. Let us see them in the hidden realities. And he reminded us to be influential, influencing people to do good, positive way. Influence that changes people for better and not for us. He reminded us how this woman was so confident that even though she had lost her only child, son of prophecy, she still believed in God, trusting in God. And because of that trust, she was able to say, it is well. And each one of us has his or her own story. Let us spread that story before God. And next year, like this time, as we have been told, may each one of us narrate his or her own story, what God had done in his life. Thank you for the benefit. I also extend my gratitude to Joseph, psalmist, and also pianist, together with one in Mlinge, singing one, helping us to pray better. Thank you, Engineer Agnes, for making sure that this transmission gets to our parishioners, and not only parishioners, all those who can access Facebook. Thank you very much. God bless you. And I also take this opportunity to thank the faithful who have participated from far away from us and those who are near, and especially the following jumuiyas that have served in this Mass. St. Peter and Paul, the anniversary of the Feast of your patron saint is tomorrow. We wish you in anticipation happy feast day. Thank you for your service, St. Augustine, St. Gregory the Great, St. Teresa of Avila, and St. Lucy. We really appreciate your generosity, and that's the faith of the Shunammite woman that we are celebrating today. Next Sunday, we shall be having the service of St. Benedict, St. Teresa of the Child Jesus, St. Michael, St. Luke, and St. Daniel Koboni. Thank you for your constant generosity and charity. Let us be charitable the way you have been told. This life is passing by. What we have received, give back to the society, especially to the most needy. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth in peace, our Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Have a blessed Sabbath.
Thank you.